Now you might say, oh yes, but the orange juice contains vitamins and so it's good for us. Well, if I put some vitamins in a can of soda, would you then think that it's good for you? Hello, angels, and welcome to the Glucose Goddess Show. Today, we're going to talk about something that has hypnotized all of us. I am talking about fruit juice. Yes, fruit juice, my dears. Listen, I grew up drinking it. My mom drank it. We made it fresh squeezed at home. It was at school. It is in all hotel breakfast rooms. It's everywhere. But the thing is, today I'm going to teach you exactly why it's not the health food that you think it is. And in fact, my opinion is that fruit juice should be treated like dessert. It's there for pleasure, like a slice of chocolate cake, but it's absolutely not something to add to your diet that's going to give you health benefits. It has more downsides than it has benefits. So let's get into it. I think the main issue I see with fruit juice is that people think that because it comes from fruit, from an orange, right, then necessarily fruit juice is going to be good for them and is going to be healthy. Now, there's lots of stuff to break down here. In particular, the concept that all fruit is natural and healthy, we'll get to that in a second. But ultimately, the really good reputation of fruit juice comes down to money. Money, money, money. And the fruit juice industry marketing this product as this amazing health thing, when actually it's not. So we've all heard or maybe seen a press article telling us that fruit juice has vitamins in it, therefore it's really good for you. And this then seeps into popular culture. You see health halos on the bottle of fruit juice that says 100% natural, good for you. Maybe you speak to a doctor or somebody who also believes that and who says fruit juice is a great source of vitamin. And they might cite some scientific studies to back up this claim. And in particular, there's one scientific study that's a really good example. So a 2021 review called Fruit Juices, Are They Helpful or Harmful? An evidence review. And so if you look at the scientific paper and you look at the conclusion, it says, in conclusion, fruit juice appears to offer more benefit than risk, and there appears to be no justification for discouraging juice within a balanced diet for children and adults. So this seemingly serious scientific review paper is telling us that fruit juice has no side effects. So obviously, if you read this, you might think, oh, therefore it's part of a balanced diet and I should be drinking it. Now, here's the kicker, and that's where you always need to look at the authors of a paper and the source of funding. If you look at the funders of this paper, so the people who paid for this research to happen, because research is not free, the funders are a consortium of orange producers, juice manufacturers, and packaging companies based in Europe and Brazil under the umbrella of the European Fruit Juice Association. So here you have industry very clearly funding research that is beneficial to their product. You have people who make fruit juice and sell it as the main source to make money for their company and their shareholders, and then fund research telling everybody that fruit juice is healthy. So you have to be super cautious. And unfortunately, there's a lot of this stuff in scientific studies. So you always have to double check who funded this and what's actually going on here. So the fruit juice industry is making a lot of money selling you essentially water with sugar in it. We'll get to that in a second. But I just want to mention, it's not your fault that you've heard that fruit juice is healthy. It's not your fault that it's been part of our culture for such a long time. There's a lot of money in here. But that's what this is. It is a money maker for fruit juice companies. So keep that in mind next time you have a glass. Now, let's look at the idea that fruit juice is natural because it comes from fruit. And fruit is natural, right? Not so fast. In order for me to explain fruit to you, I have to talk to you about dogs. So, gray wolves are the ancestor of all of the dog breeds that we see today, from golden retrievers to Dalmatians. Gray wolves were the original ancestor, and what humans did is they took gray wolves and they bred the nicest gray wolves together, maybe the softest gray wolf together, etc., etc., until they could create all these different species and breeds of dogs. Why did humans do this? Various reasons. They needed dogs to help them with farming, or maybe they just wanted domesticated dogs to enjoy as a pet. So humans have been controlling the creation of these different species of dogs for millennia and millennia and millennia. Until today, we have species such as the Chihuahua, which clearly are not natural. They come from this selective breeding that humans did. But that doesn't only happen with dogs. That has happened with a lot of things. In particular, with fruit. This orange is not natural. Oranges actually do not exist in nature. They are the product of humans breeding different species of fruit together to create this orange. And the orange is not the only example. If you look at, for example, bananas, ancestral bananas, so the way that nature intended them to be, are really small, full of seeds, and not very sweet. Even if you look at ancestral apples, they're tiny and tart and not sweet at all. The fruit that we eat today that you find at your supermarket are not natural. They are the result of human selective breeding to make these into products that are highly palatable, that are really rich in sugar, that are quite low in fiber, and that are very easy to eat. I know this probably comes as a surprise because we always think that the fruit we see in the supermarkets is, you know, comes from nature and is natural, but that's really not the case. So that's the first thing I wanted you to know. An orange or any other fruit is not natural. It is a human-made product. And I'm not talking GMOs made in a lab here. I'm talking about just breeding different crops and different plants together to create the perfect fruit. That being said, I don't hate fruit. I think that a piece of whole fruit is a totally fine thing to eat because even though modern fruit contain a lot of sugar, they also contain fiber. Mm-hmm. This contains fiber. The fiber is what is keeping this orange structurally intact. The fiber is the reason this orange doesn't turn to liquid in my hand. And fiber, when we eat it, so when we eat an orange, for example, we're eating the sugar in the orange, yes, but we're also ingesting the fiber. And the fiber acts as a protective mesh in our intestine and slows down how quickly all of the sugar from the fruit is arriving into our bloodstream. So as a result, a piece of whole fruit is actually a really good thing to eat if you want to eat something sweet. But now, here is where the issue starts. The issue starts when we denature a piece of fruit that is already not natural. So when we denature a piece of fruit, when we take an orange, and for example, if we juice it, what are we actually doing when we're juicing it to create this orange juice like we see here? In order to create orange juice from an orange, we are extracting the water and the sugar, and we are throwing away, you guessed it, the fiber. Orange juice contains very little fiber. And when you juice an orange at home and you throw away the used orange that's been completely emptied of all its water, well, you're throwing away all of that really beneficial, healthy fiber. Now, when you pour yourself a glass of orange juice, whether it is freshly squeezed or from the supermarket, you are pouring in your glass water and a lot of sugar. How much sugar, are you wondering? About 22 grams of sugar per glass of orange juice. So let me show you how much 22 grams of sugar actually gives us in terms of sugar cubes. Here, that's 22 grams of sugar. That is 6 sugar cubes. That's the amount of sugar in one glass of juice. And now here on the right, now, what is this? 7 sugar cubes, about 27 grams of sugar. Can you guess what that is trying to represent? That is the amount of sugar in a can of Coca-Cola. So look, on the left, the amount of sugar in a glass of orange juice, and on the right, the amount of sugar in a can of Coca-Cola. Now, what's really important to understand here is that your body doesn't care whether the sugar came from an orange and is now in a glass of orange juice, or whether the sugar came from a beetroot and is now in a can of Coca-Cola. To your body, it is the same molecules. It is processed the same, and it has the same impact on your brain health, on your hormones, on the creation of cravings, on aging, on inflammation, on your skin, on your risk of diabetes. The source of the sugar does not matter to your body. And I want to show you two graphs. The first comparison graph that you see here is an orange versus an orange juice. And as you can see, when you have orange juice, because that protective fiber is not there anymore, you see a much bigger glucose spike in your body than if you ate the whole orange that contained the protective fiber. Now, the second graph I want to show you is comparing a glass of orange juice to a can of soda. As you can see, from the perspective of your glucose levels and of how much sugar you're ingesting, they're very similar. Now, you might say, oh yes, but the orange juice contains vitamins, and so it's good for us. Well, if I put some vitamins in a can of soda, would you then think that it's good for you? Would you then drink it happily, thinking you're doing something good for your body? Probably not, because you understand that the amount of sugar in a can of soda is just detrimental for your health. Well, it's pretty much the same amount of sugar you get in a glass of orange juice. So that's a really important concept to understand. It's not because the sugar came from an orange and is now in the form of an orange juice that it's very different to the sugar in a can of soda, which, by the way, came from also a plant, a beetroot or a cane. I want you to know that sugar is not nutrition. We don't need sugar for energy. We don't need sugar to live. Sugar is there for pleasure. In high doses, it's a toxin, and it's quite bad for our health. It's so bad, in fact, that a lot of agencies, for example, the American Heart Association, say that you should not have more than 25 grams of sugar per day if you're a woman, and no more than 36 grams of sugar per day if you're a man. Now, if you recall, one glass of orange juice has 22 grams of sugar. So that's almost your daily allowance in sugar completely gone. And this is an upper limit of how much sugar you should be eating or drinking. It's not a recommended amount. The ideal amount of sugar is zero. And personally, if I'm going to eat some sugar or drink some sugar during the day, I would much rather spend it on a delicious chocolate cake that I love, or my favorite dessert, instead of drinking it first thing in the morning and then essentially having blown out the entire budget of sugar that is going to be okay for my body to process for the whole day. So sugar in this orange juice is going to hurt you. It's going to cause glucose spikes. It's not going to lead to you having energy for the rest of the day. And on that topic, I would like to demonstrate the difference between energy and dopamine. When you eat something sweet, or when you drink some orange juice that is sweet, that sweetness activates something in your brain that can make you feel really awake. And you kind of go like, whoa, I'm waking up. You might mistake that for energy. You might think, oh, I'm having energy now. I can go about my day. I can go do stuff. I'm going to feel great. Well, actually, what you're feeling in your brain in that moment is not energy. It is dopamine. Orange juice or any other sugar that you consume, when your taste receptors sense it, sense the sweetness, they send a message to your brain. And the message goes something like this. Hello, brain, please release lots of dopamine. We just tasted the sugar. So when you eat sugar, when you taste sugar, dopamine floods your brain. And dopamine is the pleasure molecule that humans love. It's the same molecule we get when we have sex, when we play video games, when people take illegal drugs. Dopamine and pleasure is super addictive to human beings. And some sugar or some orange juice is a really easy way to get a hit. So when you eat something sweet, you're getting pleasure flooding your brain for a short amount of time. But what's also happening is that your little mitochondria, the tiny little organelles in your cells that are actually responsible for making energy for you to go about your day, they get stressed out when too much sugar arrives. They kind of go on strike and they're not able to make energy effectively anymore. So you get pleasure, short-term pleasure in your brain, dopamine, but on the inside, your cells and your organs are slowly becoming more tired and have less available energy. And if you keep doing this over and over and over again, it leads to chronic fatigue. So you're exhausted when you wake up in the morning. You feel like you could have slept 12 more hours. You're exhausted because your mitochondria are not working anymore. And what's the first thing you do? You go for the orange juice for that short-term pleasure to counteract how terrible you feel, which I totally understand. Like, when we feel like crap, reaching for sugar is an easy way to get some sort of escape. But you need to understand that on the inside, if you actually want to unlock long-term energy, you need to slow down on that sugar intake, say bye-bye to the orange juice, so that your mitochondria can retrain, regenerate, and give you all the energy in the world. So, in conclusion, fruit juice, massive marketing machine, massive money machine, not actually good for your body. Creates a big glucose spike in the morning, which leads to a glucose roller coaster for the whole day, up and down, cravings, fatigue, inflammation, poor sleep, and then you're part of this vicious cycle. If you're somebody who loves orange juice and you cannot imagine your life without it, try to maybe have it as dessert after a meal instead of first thing on an empty stomach in the morning. And one more note, even if the orange juice says organic, 100% natural, no sugar added, etc., it's still the same. Oh, and even if it says with pulp, it doesn't change anything, it's still a massive amount of sugar. And this is particularly important because the things that we eat in the morning at breakfast have an impact on the rest of our day. And if we have a big glucose spike at breakfast, we're gonna feel like crap the whole day and be victims to cravings and fatigue. So it's super important that in the morning we have a savory breakfast. A savory breakfast will change the game for you, especially if you're somebody who's tired, suffers from cravings, and somebody who hopes that their health is gonna get better as they age, not get worse. Well, then savory breakfast is the key. There's a link in the description to this episode where you can go to my savory breakfast guide. You can get a bunch of free savory breakfast recipes to get started. And that's all we have time for today. Thank you for being here. Lots of love. I'll see you next time.